Good evening, Rahul. Peak secularism is how I would define it. Peak secularism is when Hindus have to beg for a bit of land in their own country to celebrate their festival for a day. This while governments, both center and state, have usurped hundreds of thousands of acres of Hindu temple land exclusively. Peak secularism is when 70,000 cases are pending in the Supreme Court, but it has time to hear at the 11th hour and then stay a high court verdict allowing Hindus to celebrate on a disputed land. Two issues here, Rahul, and both, please allow me to delve into them. Number one, the Muslims, let's be very honest, are under no obligation to follow the Ganga Jamni Tehzeeb and all that bunkum of Bhai Chara. Their scriptures specifically ask them not to. As Pushpendra Kulshrest quips, Bhai Chara karte rehte ho, are pata to lagao, bhai kaun hai, chara kaun hai? So why should the Muslims exceed even an inch? They shouldn't. I mean, are we trying to reinvent the wheel here? The essence of Azan is, quote, there is no God but Allah and no one has the right to be worshipped but Allah, 4062. This is amplified through the loudspeaker 5 times a day, whole year round. Rahul, considering anyone else other than Allah as a deity, worshipping it, bowing before it, is expressly forbidden. 17, 22, 23, 1240, 364, 555. Al-Kufra Milatun Wahida. Disbelievers are one nation. Quote, do not forget that disbelievers are allies of one another. 873. Do not make disbelievers guardians. 551. Let not disbelievers take disbelievers as allies except when taking precaution against them in prudence. 328. Do not take disbelievers as friend unless they convert and kill them if they refuse. 489. Also, remember how the best of friends gave away the locations of Hindus like Kanhaiya Lal and Kole, who supported Nupur, so they could be beheaded. So why do you force Bhai Chara upon someone, Bhai? And if you do, they will play the victim card of being denied roads and grounds to offer namaz. Dara hua Musalman. All around us, all we see are dara hua Musalmans, Rahul. From Jammu, where dara hua Musalmans are shouting from top of mosques that they will behead Nupur Tiwari, to Hubli, where dara hua Musalmans are pouring onto streets because some Hindu kid photoshopped a Bhagwa flag. From Aurangabad, where dara hua Musalmans are rioting in the streets because someone said Aurangzeb was a mass murderer, to Kerala, where dara hua Musalmans are celebrating the Mopla massacre of Hindus. Everywhere you look, all we see are dara hua Musalmans. Number two is a fitting slap, resounding one at that, on the face of the government that loves to call itself secular, but treats Hindus as third-class citizens. Hindus have to beg, as I said, for waqf land, disputed one, to celebrate their own festival when the governments of both center and state have usurped hundreds of thousands of acres of temple land and are responsible for more than 100,000 temples, losing lakhs of crores in rental income. Welcome to the Islamic Republic of India. This is not our future anymore, Rahul. This is now our present. Get used to it. Please allow me a couple of minutes, because let me be very clear, Rahul. Some people may not like it, but let me be clear. In this country, a Dalit lynched by a Muslim mob is considered a suicide, not murder. But if it was the other way around, it would not only be a murder of the victim, but also of democracy and justice. This is how the gangrenous cabal of propagandists have twisted the narrative. So while Jai Bhim is unconditional, Jai Bhim is conditional upon the perpetrator not being a meme. We have seen this play out almost every day since 2014 by these gangrenous selectivists who claim they speak truth to power, but power to them is always Modi. Even when hate crimes happen in non-BJP ruled states, even now, they will try and convince you that this was not a communal hate crime. So what qualifies as a communal hate crime has now been reduced to media's own judgment. The mob didn't know that the victim was a kafir or a Dalit, or are you going to demarcate their ire into religion and non-religion components? Take the case of Palghar very briefly. The ready identification of a saffron-clad sadhu is not enough. What if instead the victim was a skull-cap-wearing, sherwani-clad, bearded Maulana brought out by the UP police and gifted to the lynchers with the BJP minister looking on? Would the media still have maintained it as a non-communal crime? Hell no. You cannot cure these propagandists, Rahul. They're like the Rakt Beej. Their every drop of blood spawns more of the same. They have been silent on more than 119 Muslim mob hate attacks on Hindus, Dalits and non-Dalits over the past 3 years, including Bharat Yadav, who was lynched after being called a kafir, including in Ranchi, where a Muslim mob segregated bus passengers based on their religion before wanting to set it on fire, including vandalizing a temple in Delhi while chanting Allahu Akbar and Nara Takbir, including lynching poor Gangaram because he dared to file a police complaint when his daughter was abducted, including going on an arson and murderous rampage in Bangalore over alleged blasphemy by a Dalit, including breaking a Ambedkar statue, running amok with sports, trashing Dalit families after they objected to a Dalit girl Sarita being assaulted by a Muslim, including nearly lynching a Dalit Jayant Bhatti for daring to wear a Pathan suit, threatening to kill him if he wears it again. None of these attacks elicit any outrage. Right from the fake church attack narrative and running selective hate trackers to multiple stories of fake Jai Shri Ram slogan triggering, they have perfected selective outrage. So we knew who Akhlaq was. But do we know who was Banu or Kitaram Bhil or Sahwant Rathod or Vidhu Jain or Ayub or Farooq or Bharat? But now Indians have seen through their propaganda, Rahul. They have seen through it. Good friend Tehseen, because I want to rebut him and it's very important. Navika, I'll tell you what the real tragedy is. The tragedy is that witnesses or observers like us pick out tragedies from what has been a rolling genocide. And Mr. Pandit would know it more than anyone else. What happened in Kashmir is a rolling genocide, and to pick out one massacre, one incident, betrays our ignorance of what that genocide really was. And here I want to put Tehseen on the dock, because right on your show all those months ago, I hope I won't be interrupted by my good friend Tehseen, he called Kashmir Files a jhooti propaganda film. This was by far, I'm sorry Tehseen, the most disgusting of your affronts. Please allow me.
I never did. Anand, you're factually wrong.
Anand Ranganathan. Allow Anand Ranganathan to make his point. And if there is something you object to, you can come in later.
Please, he called, Navika, I was on the show. I really did not want Tehseen to be interrupting me. He called Kashmir Files a propaganda film. And let me tell him, does he know about the Nadimar massacre that the film truthfully depicted, where Zia Mustafa, he lined up 23 unsuspecting Kashmiri Hindus and shot them point blank? And as he was escaping, he heard a baby cry, Tehseen, Ye karwaun chupe, said his friend. And the baby became the 24th victim. Is this jhoot, Tehseen? Do you know about Girja Tiku, who was raped and cleaved into two by a mechanical saw while she was alive? Is this jhoot? Do you know about BK Ganju, who hid inside a rice barrel when jihadis came looking for him? And his Muslim neighbor informed on him, Ganju was shot dead. Rice laced with his blood was fed to his wife. Is this jhoot? The slogans raised from mosque on 19 Jan, Ralif, Salif, Galif, deaths to kafirs, Pandit, leave your women behind, Nizam-e-Mustafa. Is this all jhoot? Answer, Tehseen, you owe us an answer. Navika, let it be known that this phrase Jai Bheem Jai Meem is as fictional and as fairy tale a phrase as India is a secular country. You know, in this country, you can attack a Dalit, you can lynch a Dalit, and if a Muslim mob does it, it is considered a suicide, not a murder. But if it was the other way around, if I were to turn it around, it would not only be a murder of the victim, but also of democracy and justice. This is how this gangrenous cabal of propagandists have twisted the narrative. This is how. They have been silent, Navika, on more than 190 Muslim mob attacks on Hindus, Dalits and non-Dalits over the past 3 years, including Bharat Yadav, who was lynched after being called a kafir, including in Ranchi, same place in Jharkhand, where a Muslim mob segregated, Navika, yes, segregated bus passengers based on their religion before wanting to set it on fire, including vandalizing a temple in Delhi while chanting Allahu Akbar and Narae Takbir, including lynching poor Gangaram because he dared to file a police complaint when his daughter was abducted, including going on a ransom and murderous rampage in Bangalore over alleged blasphemy by a Dalit, including breaking a Ambedkar statue, running amok with sports, trashing Dalit families after they objected to a girl, Dalit girl, Sarita, being assaulted by a Muslim, including nearly lynching a Dalit, Jayanti Bhatti, for daring to wear a Pathan suit. Can you believe it? Threatening to kill him if he wears the Pathan suit again. Navika, none of these attacks elicit any outrage. Right from the fake church attacks narrative and running selective hate trackers to multiple storing a fake Jai Shri Ram slogan triggering, they have perfected selective outrage. So we know who Akhlaq was, who Junaid was, but do we know who was Banu or Dalit Khitaram Bhil or Savant Rathod or Vidhu Jain or Ayub or Farooq or Bharat? So while Jai Bhim is unconditional, Jai Bhim is conditional upon the perpetrator not being a meme. We have seen this play out almost every day since 2014 by these gangrenous selectivists who claim they speak truth to power, and convince you that this was not a communal hate crime. So what qualifies as a communal hate crime, Navika? Now that the media has his own judgment for it, the mob, they know that the victim was a kafir or a Dalit, or that whole family or group of families were Dalits, or are you going to demarcate their ire into religion and non-religion components? Very briefly, Navika, take the case of Palghar.
Navika, I won't take more than 30 seconds because what I want to say is very important. You see, there are people with agenda who are running and fixing the narrative. How do we expose that? How do we correct it? We can only correct it using data, concrete data, because selectivity has gone to such an extent, and I'm giving you examples. These are reports by Times of India. Muslim barbers refuse to give Dalits a haircut. Let me quote. Quote, if Dalits take haircut, the towels become dirty. This is in Moradabad village. There are so many instances like this in villages. So, you know, you have to quote, cite these instances, Navika, because otherwise the selectivity, these selectivities, they will take it to such an extent that they will say only Hindus are discriminating. Why? Whereas there is equal discrimination by Muslims on Dalits as well. Nobody knows this because it never comes into the news. It never elicits any outrage.